Amina has been working at IOM for 3 years. She has a reputation for being hardworking, dependable, and friendly. She has been a little forgetful recently and absent during working hours. Her colleagues also feel like she has been particularly impatient with them and frequently asks them to carry out her tasks. One colleague in particular, Mohammed, feels like Amina is delegating some of her responsibilities to him. Since he is not Amina's subordinate and should not have to do her work, Mohammed decides that it's time to talk to her. What the team does not know is that Amina is going through a very difficult period in her personal life, having to take care of a very sick parent on her own. The following two scenarios will demonstrate how the conversation between Mohammed and Amina could go. You will see how talking about the same issue can have very different consequences depending on how the issue is addressed. The first example is a conversation where both colleagues do not use active listening. They are not communicating in a way to understand the other person's perspective.
Hi, Amina. Can I speak to you for a few minutes?
Hi, sure. Come in. What is this about?
I'm here because the whole team and I find that you are being unprofessional recently. You are forcing your work on us, especially on me. You are not our supervisor. Also, you keep disappearing throughout the day without notice.
Excuse me? I am working as much as all of you on this project. Team members are supposed to help each other out. I am not doing anything out of line.
If you cannot do your part, why don't you just quit this project? We cannot keep working with you like this.
You are so rude to just enter my office and attack me like this. Who do you think you are?
I am rude? You are bullying us into doing your work. Don't you see this as a problem?
Please just get out of my office. You have interrupted my work enough for one day.
The second example is a conversation where both colleagues use active listening. The objective in any difficult conversation should be to leave the discussion on good terms with the other person.
Hi, Amina. Can I speak to you for a few minutes?
Hi, sure. Come in. What is this about?
We have known each other for a while and we get along well, right? I know you are a hard worker and we all value you in the team.
Yeah, we're a great team.
I wanted to meet with you because it has been a couple of months now that I feel like you are less present at work. It feels like you have been delegating your work to the team and to me the most. I just wanted to let you know that when you do this, it makes me feel like you think I work for you rather than with you. It has just come to the point where I feel tired and frustrated.
Have I really been delegating that much work? I thought I was managing everything well. I didn't think I was overwhelming anyone because I felt like we were all helping each other out. The truth is, I have been taking care of my mother, who is dying, all on my own. I can't afford to have a nurse at home, so I often have to rush at odd hours to go take care of her. I did not realize I was putting so much pressure on you. I did not mean to.
Oh, I see. Very sorry to hear about your mother. I hope she is okay. So, if I have understood you correctly, you have been absent from work and asking us to cover for you because you have been caring for your mother.
That's right. It was never my intention to make you feel like I had some kind of authority over all of you. I should have spoken to the whole team about this sooner. I just felt embarrassed to let you all know that I'm struggling a little.
There is nothing to be embarrassed about. I understand it's hard taking care of a parent. Thank you for telling me about it now. I'm relieved to hear that you are not trying to make us feel like we are your subordinates, like I thought. How can we find a solution to this?
Maybe I should take a short leave so I can fully concentrate on taking care of my mother and to find an alternative way to make this work.
Okay, that's a good idea. Maybe we could discuss this with the whole team and our supervisor so they are aware.
Yes, let's do that. Let's also have a team meeting when I come back to think of alternatives that will work for all of us, once we've had some time to think. Thank you for coming to talk to me about this.